In this video, we show how to correctly install the PIKOCI 5060 inverter from KOSTAL. Please note the information relating to installation and proper use of the device. In addition to the PIKOCI 5060, the scope of delivery includes the following accessories: a quick start guide, a wall mount, 3 screws with nuts and plain washers, a lock screw, a cover for the communication connection, an installation kit comprising plug seals for installation communication cables with 3 plugs, plug connector for the communication interface, core end sleeves for communication cables, a Wi-Fi antenna, DC plug connectors, and a disassembly tool. The type plate on the left side of the inverter contains the serial number, technical details, and warnings. The connection area can be found on the underside of the housing. The device provides various interfaces for connecting to other inverters, sensors, energy meters, or the internet. Depending on device type, up to 12 DC connections are provided to connect the PV generators. To make these connections, use the pair of Amphenol H4 connectors provided with the corresponding contacts. Next to the DC connectors panels, you will find communication interfaces for the PIKOCI 5060. The 2 Ethernet interfaces in the COM2 connector panel allow the inverter to be integrated into the local network. The inverter can use a network connection to transmit its data to the KOSTAL solar portal via the network. The multipoint connector has an RS-485 interface and digital inputs for ripple control receivers and the grid and systems protection connection. The cable aperture next to the COM2 connector panel allows the main cable to be guided into the inverter's terminal compartment. The status LEDs are located on the front of the housing. These provide information about the inverter's operational status. Attach the wall mount to a fixed mounting face. Lift the PIKOCI 5060 onto the mount with the help of at least 2 other people, and fit the lock screw supplied. Ensure that the DC switches are in the off position, and that the AC line is voltage-free and secured to prevent it from being switched back on. Remove the screws from the bottom housing cover and take off the cover. Unscrew the cable gland sealing ring and press in the protective diaphragm. Guide the individual main cable wires through the sealing ring and then through the cable aperture in the inverter's terminal compartment. Use ring cable lugs, M8, to continue the wires to the AC connection terminal, following the label. Start with the PE cable. Screw the sealing ring back down with the cable on the inverter. The AC cable is now connected and can be properly laid in the sub-distribution. Close the terminal compartment's housing cover and screw it tight. Screw the WLAN Wi-Fi antenna provided onto the connector bolt. Note, the inverter has an extra protective conductor connection for countries requiring a second protective conductor connection. Establish the internet connection with your inverter at the COM2 connector panel. Start by releasing the screws from the cover and removing the cover. Remove the plug seal and replace it with the appropriate plug with multiple ducts, which is supplied. Guide the Ethernet cable through the COM2 cover and connect it to one of the 2 LAN RJ45 sockets. Seal the LAN cable with a sealing ring and union nut. Note: to connect an external device, such as a data logger, connect an RS-485 cable to the plug provided and connect this to the interface of the COM2 connector panel. Then establish the connection with your computer, router, or switch. Note: the second LAN RJ45 socket is used as the communication connection for further inverters. Screw the cover back onto the inverter and seal the cable with a sealing ring and union nut. If you want to record generation and consumption values or want to control the inverter's output power to the public grid, you'll have to install a KOSTAL smart energy meter. Perform the installation as described before, using the COM2 connector panel on the multipoint connector, and select the RS485A interface on the KOSTAL smart energy meter for the PIKOCI 5060. For this task, please refer to the operating manual and watch the KOSTAL videos for the smart energy meter. Now connect the PV cables with the inverter. PIKOCI 5060 uses Amphenol plug connectors of the type Helios H4. Turn DC switch on inverter to off position. Note: before connecting, check polarity of DC cables. Remove blue protective caps from connection sockets and plug pair of Amphenol H4 connectors onto the DC inputs until you hear them engaging. The order in which the connectors are connected should follow the white frame and markings on the device. Ensure an even distribution. The inverter has up to 12 DC inputs. Start with the first two PV2 connection sockets and plug the pair of connectors onto the sockets. Connect the second pair of connectors with the two PV6 connection sockets in the second connector panel. Note: if there is more than one inverter in a PV system, ensure that no cross connections occur when the PV generators are connected. If using more PV modules, start again in the left connection area and connect to the pair of connectors in the PV3 connection socket. Connect the second pair to the PV7 connection socket in the second connector panel. Activate the AC fuse and move the DC switch on the PIKOCI 5060 to the on position. The status LEDs on the front of the inverter flash green. Please refer to the operating manual for the LED operational statuses. To use your smartphone or tablet to assist with commissioning, please download the KOSTAL CI app from the App Store or Google Play Store. Activate the Wi-Fi LAN function on your tablet or smartphone and go to the Wi-Fi WLAN settings. Look for your inverter's WLAN network and select it. Enter 12345678 as the password and confirm your input. Answer the check question with stay and launch the app. The app displays the inverters it finds. Select the inverter you want to commission. Once the app reports connect, the inverter is connected. Select the settings page in the app. The app now displays various menus where you can perform various configurations. To set configure the country setting, you will need administrator access authorization. To set this up, go to User Management and then click on the Change User button.
Click on the Login as Administrator button and enter the password SuperAdmin.
Configure the settings for inverter operation. To do this, go to the Settings page and then Inverter Settings. Then select the time and date and confirm your input. Then select the grid guidelines you need in the Network Settings menu. More settings may be needed. When configuring them, please observe the grid operator's requirements. Initial commissioning is complete and the inverter is up and running. You can now configure more settings in your inverter, such as setting the country guideline, feed-in limitation, etc.